and our solvent. These are going to be four new variables that we add to our problem. We will let the model solver change these values right here. Okay. In general, we don't like these values, right? We don't want to deviate from our goals. So usually, when we're making this kind of a model, we'll do something like minimize something like that. Minimize how far away we are from our goal. Now I'd like you to be able to see that only one of these values can be non-zero. Because df minus df plus df minus df plus all have to be non-negative. Like all of our logical things, logical constraints that we've seen so far. So if we go under production, we're not going to do overproduction. Again, if we do under production, we're not going to do overproduction. So even though we add these all together in our minimization, it's not a problem because we can only overproduce or underproduce. We can't both overproduce and underproduce the same material. Okay? This is what we would do in a scenario where we consider both of these goals equally important. What we're saying is get the minimum deviation from these two goals. Try to minimize those. We could add in priority here. So for instance, what is it, question D, if goal one, which is the fuel, is twice as important as goal two, now we put some objective value here, we will just do this. And we'll double our deviation on that goal than we do from this goal right here. Right? This is two times as important as this goal, so it's twice as valuable in our objective function as this goal is right here. Okay? So this is the type of formulation that we're going to use on these problems. And we'll see how we can do this with OpenSolver next week, okay? Have a great weekend, everyone. I'll see you then on Monday.
Thanks,
you too, Kieran.